Almighty Father, what in heaven, great is thy faithfulness towards us. Thank you for this hour. Give us the Holy Spirit and guide us to the end. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and his speaker as a dragon. The two horns represents republicanism and protestantism. Republicanism means a state without a king. Protestantism means a church without a pope. The United States in prophecy. This represents one nation, and only one meets the specification of this verse in this prophecy. It points unmistakably to the United States of America, which is arising. Oh, friends, Paul writes to the Romans, if it be possible, as much as light in you, live peacefully with all men. Romans chapter 12, verses 18. But there is a point beyond which it is impossible to maintain union and harmony without the sacrifice of principle. Separation then becomes an absolute duty. The laws of nations should be respected when they do not conflict with the laws of God. But when there is collision between them, ever true disciples of Jesus Christ will say, as did the Apostle Peter, when commanded to speak no more in the name of Jesus, we ought to obey God rather than men. Acts 5 verse 29, Evangelism page 234 and 235. So friends, stand faithful. We live in the times of the end. The test for us is obedience to God. Obey, obey. If you obey, you keep God's commandments. You keep God's commandments. Let's see. It is possible for man, by yielding to Satan in the association of the world, to lose his power, to exercise his will in resisting temptation. The wiles of the enemy are constantly pressing in upon mind and soul, to bind man as captive to the force of habit, through movies, everything. Pressing in upon mind and soul, using laws to force mind and soul, to bind man as captive to the force of habit. What is the habit? Each individual soul is on trial for his life, as he given God that which belongs to him, as he surrendered to God all that is his, as his purchased possession. All who cherish the Lord as their portion in this life will be under his control, and will receive the sign, the mark of God, which shows them to be God's special possession. Christ's righteousness will go before them, and the glory of the Lord will be their reward. The Lord protects every human being who bears his sign, who bears his seal, his sign in these last days. The Bible says in Exodus chapter 31, verses 12 to 17, what is the sign of God? What is the seal of God? What is the mark of God? What is the mark of God, O friend? Let's see. Exodus 31, verse 12 to 17. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak thou also unto the children of Israel, saying, verily my Sabbath you shall keep, for it is a sign between me and you throughout your generations, that you may know that I am the Lord that does sanctify you. You shall keep the Sabbath therefore, for it is holy unto you. Everyone that defileth it shall surely be put to death. For whosoever does any work therein, that the soul shall be cut off from among his people. 6 days may work be done, but in the seventh is the Sabbath of rest, holy to the Lord. Whosoever does any work in the Sabbath day, he shall surely be put to death. Therefore, the children of Israel shall keep the Sabbath, to observe the Sabbath throughout their generations, for a perpetual covenant. It is a sign between me and the children of Israel forever. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, and on the seventh day he rested and was refreshed. Exodus 31, verse 12 to 17. This is the sign of God, his authority upon the earth. Have you obeyed him? So friends, we ought to obey God rather than men in these last days. Obey God. Follow him. Follow his way. Follow the way of God. Sorry. The recognition of God is of the highest value to every human being. All who love and serve him are very precious in his sight. He will have them stand where they are worthy representatives of the truth as it is in Jesus. Letter 77, May 1st, 1899. Friend, the cognition of God is of the highest value to every human being. All who love and serve Him are very precious in His sight. John chapter 14, verse 15, Jesus Christ said, "If you love me, keep my commandment. Those who love, thank God, they keep His commandment." The fourth commandment, the most controverted one, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. The test of love in these last days, those who serve God in these last days. So the enemy knows that if the church can be controlled by political enactments, she will lose her garments of light as did Adam and Eve. If we can lead the church to unite with the world and accept world enactments and laws, they virtually acknowledge Him as their head. Then the authority of man-made commandments will work to oppose the rule of the government of heaven. Under the leadership of Satan, the knowledge of good and evil will work to dispense with the righteous, holy enactments of God concerning the Sabbath, the observance of which is to be the sign between God and His people forever and ever. So, friend, who should we obey? We should obey God rather than men. When Satan is working steadily but sure to do away with the laws of God, he is fighting. Shall we not stand? So we should stand in a time like this. Satan's plan has taken hold with the religious world. He has created an order of things entirely his own, making void the law of God. He sits in the temple of God as God. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 3. Let no man deceive you by enemies, for that day shall not come, except they come falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, who sits in the temple of God, calling himself that is God in the temple. Satan's plan has taken hold with the religious world. He has created an order of things entirely his own, making void the law of God. He sits in the temple as God. Through his deceptive workings, he has gained in the professed Christian world all that he thought to gain in heaven, an abrogation of the law of Jehovah. Through the Roman power, he has worked to remove God's memorial and has erected a memorial of his own to sever God from his people. And today the Protestant world is estranged from God by their worship of a spurious serpent. They cannot find one iota of divine authority for doing this. Yet, full of zeal, they assert that the Lord's memorial given at creation should be ignored, despised, and trampled upon, and the first day of the week take it his place. So, what should we do then as a people? In these last days? Stand firm, friend. Stand firm in uplifting the name of God. So, every man will decide his own case by his decision in regard to the law of Jehovah. When the world will ripen for the harvest, both classes will be developed. The sentiment of every heart will be revealed. Each party will gather under its chosen leader, as loyal to God and His commandments, or as the transgressors of the law, with the first great reaper at their head. All must wait for the appointed time, until the warning shall have gone to all parts of the world, until sufficient light and evidence has been given to every soul. Some will have less light than others, but each one will be judged according to the light received. Not until the fullness of the time shall come, will the crucified and risen Savior assume his equality with God. Patiently, Jesus has waited in the heavenly courts in behalf of his people who have suffered for their loyalty to him. Patiently, Jesus waits for the gospel of the kingdom to be preached to all parts of the world, until all nations, kindreds, tongues, and people have received the light of God's word. So patiently, Jesus is waiting. Special Testimonies, volume 4, page 77, page 78, and other books. So friend, are you ready for the second coming of Jesus Christ? Be faithful, friend, in a time like this. Be faithful to the end. So, he who endeavored to change God's law by instituting a spurious Sabbath uses every device to induce men and women to unite with him in his apostasy, the papacy. God has declared that the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord, but the great apostates say, I will work at cross purposes with God. I will embargo by derogate the man of sin to take down God's memorial, the seventh day Sabbath. Thus, I will show the world that the day sanctified and blessed by God has been changed. That the day shall not live in the minds of the people. I will obliterate the memory of it. I will place in it instead a day bearing not the credentials of God, a day that cannot be a sign between God and his people. What a fight against God! What a fight against God! It's a campaign, friend. Which side will you be found in these last days? It's a campaign. Which side will you be found? Which side will you be found as a child of God in these last days? Be faithful, friend. Be faithful. Be faithful. As the crisis raging is going very fast, which side will you choose to be? Which side? Obey God and keep his commandments is the call and the test in these last days. To obey God. So we should obey God and keep his commandments, for the fourth commandment is the most controverted one, which calls people to true worship. So as we worship God, as we appreciate him, let us be faithful. Let us serve God in truth and in spirit, appreciating him. Do not follow the mark of the beast, which is the mark of the papacy, which is Sunday. Sunday is the mark of the papacy's authority, who has thought to change times and laws. Daniel chapter 7 verse 25 says that the papacy shall think to change times and laws. He has done already this, and is forcing the Christian one to follow the same. Oh friend, that is from the catechism, quote, and they are abrogated it by force, and the world is being forced to follow the same path. Will you choose the Lord of the Sabbath, his Sabbath, or will you choose the mark of the peace, that of the Antichrist, the man who is opposing God in this last day? Sure, be faithful, friend. Be faithful in a time like this. Be faithful, appreciate the name of Jesus. Appreciate the name of Jesus. I lead the people to accept this day, to place upon it the sanctity that God placed upon the seventh day. Through my vigilance, I will exert myself. The first day will be extolled, and the Protestant world will receive this spurious Sabbath as a genuine through the non-observancy of the Sabbath God instituted. I will bring Israel into contact. The words are signed between me and you throughout your generations. Exodus 31 verse 13, I will make to serve on the side of my Sabbath. Thus the world will be mine. I will be the ruler of the universe, prince of this world. Friend, that is taking possession of us. Oh friend, how can this happen? As a people, we should awaken the people of God and show them their danger in these last days, when the mark of the beast, the Sunday row, is being agitated upon the world. Should we not direct the people to the truth? Yes, we should not quiet. We should not be quiet, but show the people the danger they are in these last days. Thank you so much. As you hold fast your faith, as you stand firm in the crisis upon the land, hold fast your faith, stand firm, knowing what is coming upon the land, for all this was prophesied to come. Keep the commandment of the Lord. Do you love him? Then keep the commandments of the Lord. Observe the commandments. This is love, that you keep his commandments. And God is calling for this ever. The devil knows this, and he hates obedience to God. He hates obedience to God. The Sabbath is not Jewish. It was made for man. It is made for man, not for the Jews. Those who are calling it Jewish, they don't know that the Sabbath was made for man. Oh friend, come all to the true rest in these last days. Come all, because we know that in these last days forced worship is coming. Forced worship is coming upon the universe. Friend, be faithful. Be faithful, for forced worship is coming. The lack of divine authority will be supplied by oppressive enactments. After all the people of the earth face final test regarding God's law, what comes next? The lack of divine authority will be supplied with oppressive enactments. Political corruption is destroying love of justice. and regard for truth. And even in free America, rulers and legislators, in order to secure public favor, would yield to the popular demand for a law enforcing standard of service. It is coming. It is here, friend. All nations are calling for this. Oh, friend, get ready. Get ready. I will so control the minds under my power that God's Sabbath will be an object of contempt. A sign? I will make the observance of the seventh day a sign of disloyalty to the authorities of earth. Human law will be made so stringent that men and women will not dare observe the seventh-day Sabbath for fear of wanting food and clothing. They will join with the world in transgressing God's law, and the earth will be wholly under my dominion. When every case is decided in the courts of heaven, this covenant, that is the Ten Commandments, will be brought forth, plainly written with the finger of God. The world will be arraigned before the bar of infinite justice to receive sentence, a life measuring with the life of God for obedience and death for transgression. Oh friend, obey God, keep His commandments. God is good, God is love. In these last days, God calls upon us that we may serve Him, obey Him, and if we indeed we love Him, we keep His commandments. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for taking your time to be with us. Follow God, for the crisis is raging over the nations. The crisis is raging over the nations. Is this the United States of America which shall make a law of forced worship as they are going to call upon this? Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy, friend. Let no man deceive you in any means, for 30 days shall not come except there come a falling away fast. That man of sin, the Antichrist, be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalted himself above all that is called God. Friend, obey God. Thank you so much for joining us. God be with you. Let's pray. Father in heaven, thank you for being with us to this end. Let all be done for thy glory. Bless us and shower us with thy blessings. Speak with us to the end. In Jesus' name we pray and we believe. Amen. Goodbye.